po tiki koe tiki mai o te whanua kuku mea mai rā. Haere mai, haere mai rā, huri noa ki a koutou ngā tau I rā. Kua eke ki te rātou matata koutou pōtai tanga, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.
Please be seated. E ngā mana, e ngā reo, e ngā hou e whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of University Council members and staff of the University. I extend a special welcome to our guest speaker, Ms. Nairi Ashmore. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding 6,673 qualifications on some 6,559 students, in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 513 students will graduate in person and 69 students will graduate in absentia. Graduation is a time for celebrating our success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition and recognition befitting your success on your well-earned day of celebration. Each year, we award degrees and diplomas to some 10,000 graduands from all walks of life. Last year, for example, our spring graduands were unique in being capped in the same month as His Excellency Ban Ki-moon, Secretary General of the United Nations, on whom we bestowed an honorary Doctor of Laws. Mr. Ban encouraged us to think like global citizens and reminded us that the imagination of young people is the most powerful force in the world. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Put another way, your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification of which you should be proud. However, I also want you to think about the opportunities for research and ongoing learning at the University of Auckland. Our academic staff and postgraduate students regularly make contributions to research, discovery, and learning across a wide range of disciplines. Our research company, Auckland Uni Services Limited, the largest contract research enterprise in Australasia, has over the last decade filed more than 860 patents based on University of Auckland intellectual property and so has contributed to the growth of new and existing businesses in New Zealand and abroad. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In my annual report for 2014, I listed the top academic awards we won last year. I believe we were unique in New Zealand in receiving such a wide range of recognition and awards for teaching, research, and communications across a range of disciplines, including science, engineering, medicine, and the arts. It is without doubt an impressive list of achievements. I invite you to read the annual report and witness for yourself the success that makes us the leading university in New Zealand. I like to think of our university as an innovation engine. The more we conduct world-leading research, the more we're recognised for success. The more we win recognition for success, the more research leaders we attract, and the more groundbreaking research we undertake and publish. Through this virtuous circle, our reputation and ranking is enhanced, and we continue to grow. In time, this will become somewhat self-perpetuating. It will become part of our culture. It will have a huge impact on our economy and our society through the achievement of our students, graduates, and researchers. You can be part of this. Our collective challenge is to do even more to serve New Zealand and the world. To me, the way forward is clear. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we were doing, as illustrated by the achievements I referred to above, and by our having successfully completed last year a major project to enhance specialisation and career opportunities among our professional staff. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. 2014 was notable for our progress on construction of the engineering research facility at our Newmarket campus and a good start on construction of the new science tower on the city campus. In April of this year, Council approved a major demolition and rebuilding of the engineering undergraduate buildings on Simon Street. Together, these three projects represent an investment of over $580 million in high-quality facilities for our staff and students. So as you graduate today, please consider my earlier suggestion that you reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world. To illustrate how important this is, I was reading a Microsoft report recently where one of their development staff was reported as saying, around half of today's occupations won't continue to exist in the future as the pace of change accelerates. So my message to you is to be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, we should be spending more on universities to strengthen our national economy, not less. But that's enough of the issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. Our guest speaker today, Nairi Ashmore, has been the principal of Tangaroa College in Otara since 2005, during which time she has made this urban multicultural secondary school a first choice for parents seeking a place of education for their children. The school offers education that prepares adolescents for successful careers and helps them become citizens who make meaningful contributions to their communities. With her board and about 100 staff, she has placed a strong emphasis on providing cultural identity and self-awareness learning opportunities that assist the students to be proud of who they are. Last year, Nairi was seconded to the University of Auckland Centre for Educational Leadership, where she contributed to the work of the First Time Principals Program and the Growing Great Leaders and Open to Learning initiatives. She has a wide range of skills and attributes, including relationship building, change leadership, culturally responsive leadership, and coaching and staff development. Nairi began her doctoral studies at this university last year. It is my pleasure to welcome you here today, Nairi, and I know you will provide us with some valuable insights. I invite you to address us.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, members of the University, graduates, families and friends. Kia ora, kia orana, talofa lava, maloe lele, whakalofa lahi atu. Thank you for the opportunity to address you all today. I feel humbled and honoured to stand before you as part of the alumni at the University of Auckland and as the principal of Tangaroa College. Tangaroa College is the recipient and benefactor of many previous graduates of this fine university, and today is no exception. Tangaroa College has both a staff member in the School of Social Work and an education graduating today. First and foremost, I want to give my sincere and heartfelt congratulations to you all sitting here. Your outstanding accomplishments and achievements are no mean feat. The passion, the commitment, the sacrifice, the heartache, the discipline, and the sheer joy of finishing, achieving, and succeeding is fantastic. Again, well done to you all. My own recent experience embarking on further study has reminded me just how enormous the challenge of achieving a university qualification can be. Not only are we spending hours and hours writing, reading, discussing, reviewing, then rewriting, and more reading and rewriting, we are often doing this alongside trying to balance working full-time and tending to our family commitments. So in recognising and celebrating your achievements today, we also have to acknowledge that this does not happen in isolation. I'd like to also recognise other very important people here. Your parents, your siblings, your whānau, your families, and the contribution they have made to your success. Their support has most likely been imperative to your success. They have enabled you to spend the time and energy required to achieve at the heights you have achieved. Their support has afforded you the opportunity to find that much needed balance. Your achievement here today is their achievement as well. I was fortunate to hear a presentation recently to a group of secondary school student leaders from a graduate and her dad sitting in this auditorium today. She shared her story of how her education journey had afforded her a wealth of experiences and opportunities she may never have had. She talked about how this was made possible through the enormous support and sacrifice that her whole family, and particularly her parents and her older siblings, made so she was able to achieve a university education. so many sacrifices. Her achievement was their achievement, visible in the photos she had, her and her dad shared with the secondary students. Congratulations to all of the families and whānau of our graduates. I have just two further messages I want to share with you. It is so important that you understand how fortunate and lucky you are to be here, incredibly lucky to have a university education. I serve a community and a secondary school that have a vision that their children will one day be able to achieve a university education. For many and varied reasons, this opportunity for some of those students will not be possible. It could be that they are not as lucky as you. Don't take your university qualifications for granted. With graduating today comes responsibility. Do something with it that is really rewarding and satisfying for you and for those you choose to serve, and make the biggest impact. Every day I feel extremely privileged to be able to serve the community, the students and the teachers within my school. Be a teacher. Please be a teacher. Teachers are the most important people. You don't have to do it forever, but if you are in doubt about what to do, be an amazing teacher. Even if you're not a teacher, be a teacher. Share your ideas, your passion, savour in what you learn and share it. Finally, define yourself by what you love. We sometimes have a predisposition to define ourselves by what we are opposed to. Express yourself by things you are passionate about. Be demonstrative. Give someone a standing ovation if you think that it warrants it. Send someone thank you cards if you think that is what needs to happen. Be proactive. The next phase of your life begins now. Life can be tough, sometimes happy and sometimes not so happy. Fill your life with learning as much as you can, about as much as you can, taking pride in whatever you are doing, having passion and being passionate, sharing ideas and thinking critically, be hard on your own opinions, being enthusiastic and aiming to make others happy. This is an incredibly exciting time. Don't rush. If you don't know what it is you want to do for the rest of your life, don't panic. Teach. You are incredibly successful and talented and a credit to your families. Thank you all for the opportunity to share with you today. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Thank you, Nari, for that insightful and inspiring speech. We need more people teaching. This is a meeting of Council in Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Professor Aitken, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduate Diploma in Education, Judy Elizabeth Dodson. Pauline Jane Holland. Carolyn Ann McPeak. Sandra Marie Pierce. Yvette Margaret Phillips. Michelle Sanderson. Graduate Diploma in Teaching, Early Childhood Education, Sina Beverly Akoi. Mariam Alassadi. Ning Bao. Rosie Maimiti Basting. Maaiki Jane Bendel. Nicole Heather Booth. Christy Louise Chatt. Nordiana Binti Dowd. Mailing Pauline Davids. Vidya Elavakunath. Margaret Barbosa Escorcio. Atiya Mohammed Ikhlas Farid. Goriti Fernandez. Brahman Janice Scudder. Yu Yung Guo. Colette Annie Kane. Jiyeon Lee. Jun Yu. Kathleen Ann Carbonell Madrigal. Lisa Carey Matthews. Desmond McCauley. Sandy Christina Mead. Victoria Innocencia Musati. Noemi Natividad. Shitin Ong. Abigail Elise Parsons. Krista Louise Petrenko. Shakti Poonam. Amanda Jane Preston. Paloma Ta'iri Reyes. Ada Ik Karuni. Deepika Roy. Victoria Sylvia Mary Sakiria. Vicky Leanne Sargent. Sunila Devi Sharma, Cherie Karen Small, Michelle Elizabeth Surgina, Denise Tatafu Pohiva, Samantha Ann Teo Chang, Emma Louise Van Bellen, Eloise Marie Wilcock, Graduate Diploma in Teaching Primary, Stephen Callum Anderson, Atwa Asafo, Adele Carita Nadia Alvaki, Maxine Roma Santos Benson, Jean Louise Barrett, the late Margot Brebner Bergen, Kate Emma Bias, Danielle Lauren Bowden, Gareth Leslie Zander Breton, Joshua Luke Burrows, Anna Michelle Kasten, Tegan Rose Cheeseman, Desmond Stephen Chin, Eliza Jane Clark, Tamsin Collins, Stuart Andrew Crook, Danny Marie Crosby, Ella Rachel Francis Denis, Stacey Ray Dewar, Caitlin Van Vaas Doyle, Maxine Carioca da Silva, Kirsten Michelle Ellis, Niall May Emery, Elizabeth Dawn Ferris, Victoria Louise Fuller, Bruce Peter Gabbatees, Marie Carol Galichan, Caesar Ian Junior Navarro Galvin, Joe In Chow Gong, Rose Francis Gorange, Jasmine Amber Gao, Wallace Elaine Pitty Grout Brown, Madison Minette Guppy, Sarah Elizabeth Hall, Maria Maya Hallis, Miriam Joan Hartman, Lisa Jill Harton, Kelly Lee Haysom, Laura Catherine Hillier, Olivia Ellen Howen, Catherine Ione, Matthew Stephen Jackson. Walla Mohammed Hussein Abdul Rahman Jibrail. Ji Yi Kim. Jok Hyun Kim. Amy Marrakesh Lloyd. Penelope Annie Lowe. Nadia Ann Lowe. Tegan Jade Mahi. Alia Amina Malik. Eleanor Frances Rose Maudsley. Stephen Peter McKenzie. Jade Robin May Miles. Emma Jane Daisy Morris. Claire Anthea Moss. Nicholas Colin Mulligan. Amelia Annabella Nicolau. Christina Jo Nutt. Erin Michelle Oates. Stephanie Orchard. Hannah Jane O'Shea. Joanna Lorna Paluk. Samantha Elizabeth Connell Paxton. Kushbu Darshita Prasad. Shivashna Prasad. Trina Margaret Rose Quinlan. Amanda Jane Ray. Georgia Lee Reed. Shannon Roberts. Kate Hannah Rook. Nicole Lee Rowland. Ashley Marie Tuila Ryan. Charisse Amara Scanlon. Amy Elizabeth Snackenberg. Helen Jane Scrivener. Emma Page Smith. Nari Ann Smith. Louise Spora. Susan Elizabeth Stanny. Shannon Rose Starr. Annalise Beatrice Stevens. Shona Leanne Hames. Tames, I'm sorry. Alama Pesa Tola. Catherine Faye Taylor. Hannah Jane Thomas. Kate Danielle Tilley. Samantha Truter. Joanne Sheila Walker. Fiona Meredith Grace Wickens. Jamie Elizabeth Claire Wilkinson. Lindsay Jean Wills. Sizit Cecilia Wong. Nicola Monique Zimmerman. Bachelor of Education Teaching. Florentia Mafaleo Afamui. Carol Agate. Samantha Marianne Albert. Ashley Kieran Ellington. Stacey Renee Anderson. Melissa Leanne Ensign. Anita Madeline Louise Armstrong. Senior Scholar, Education and Social Work, Robin Hillary Aston. Senior Scholar, Education and Social Work, Tony Megan Atkinson. Sally Louise Averne. Susan Mary Barrett. Senior Scholar, Education and Social Work, Rebecca Joyce Barrett. Marika Lena Bailey. Kate Phyllis Berry. Catherine Ann Bigelow. Nicola Joanne Blakey. Hayley Marie Burson. Samantha Jeanette Bound. Amber Lee LaCardia Brewer. Catherine Elizabeth Brown. Ruth Lynette Brown. Kirsten Madeline Ellen Burr. Hala Salahadin Abdul Kako. Hannah Rose Calvert. Juliet Marie Cantwell. Joseph Stanley Carey. Esther May Carr. Victoria Lee Cartwright. Jesse Kayan Chan. Gemma Leith Chase. Dawn Cha Chen. Jung Choi. Madison Grace Elizabeth Howen Cooper. Sarah Ann Benita Cope. Tracy Ann Rahira Cox. Kelsey Georgia Dalton. Tessa Jane Deutschler. Yvette Dick. Catherine Elizabeth Ellen Petahera Dixon. Amy Rose Donald. Ella Grace Dow. Amanda Kirsten Drabble. Chante Celestine Duval. Ratane Sebastian Edelson. Briar Catherine Edwards. Tony Louise Engelbrick. Kate Mary Evans. Joshua Charles Foy Farrell. Lauren Susan Fenton. Tegan Joy Firth. Soraya Lucy Franklin. Taryn Zara Fennell. Candace Marie Hotawaitara Gardner. May Lise Ngasiata. Marlene George. Vanessa Elizabeth Gill. Christine Gabrielle Denise Catherine Gillette. Tiangi Glasgow. Alison Glenn. Bonnie Rose Gray. Cherie Gay Gregg. Timothy Peter Griffiths. Rebecca Marie Grindle. Tanya Rowena Gumtal. Josephine Barry Hall. Sung Hee Han. Christine Lisa Hansen. Julie Harper. Cheryl Faye Hartnell. Rachel Louisa Hassan. Victoria Rosemary Hawkins. Latisha Victoria Healy. Lana Shirlene Hedewini. Kimberly Amy Hyam. Zoe Isabel May House. Yan Huang. Catherine Jane Wilson Hulst. Venicione. Milan Ishibashi. Madeline Louise Jackson. Tina Marie Jerome Fong. Lucy Joan Johnston. Rebecca Louise Jones. Maria Danielle Carpene. Tupofo Sera Capatini. Amanda Jordan Maureen Kemp. Kelly Ann Kennard Gill. Elise Donnell Kerr. Sing Yong Q. Ji Hyun Kim. Rowan Brendan King. Alexandra Marie Kravanik. Marie Mary Kutia.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Eva Ding on flute will now perform The Great Train Race by Ian Clarke. Thank you. Thank you, Eva, for that outstanding piece of work. Would you join with me in thanking Eva once more? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching, Andrew Peter Lawrence. Song Kyung Lee. Keely Selena Leilua. Carl Eden Leung Choi. Jia Jing Li. Jia Yi Lim. Li Ling. Briar Chu Lei Lister. Crystal Hu Tong Liu. Chanel Lobo. Christina Logie. Lucan Lowe. April Luxmore. Claire Emily Lyford. Babette Esther Martha Maas. Leonie Jo Mackay. Lisa Alice McMillan. Tasia Lesieli Murphy. Maria Yvonne Elena Maiava. Neelam Mungabai. Grace Mariner Duncan. Jasmine Marie Martin. Brittany Kate Masterson. Lynette Anna Vagesi Matthew. Rebecca Patricia McCulloch. Ashley Jane Carlisle McIntosh. Leanne Deborah McKenzie. Jonathan Paul McPhail. Danielle Jane McQuinn. Seelaw Dorothy Matai. Nasesha Mohan. Celeste Julia Mulman. Nicole Liana Moore. Senior Scholar, Education and Social Work, Nicola Rachel Morris. Basilea Vaifo'o Mulianga. Zainab Mula. Kate Helen Mullins. Carla Maria Newman. Amber Grace Nicholson. Michael Andre Niehaus. Grace Karen Nimmo. Anita Condessa Nin. Tarina Lee Nin. Kelly Joy Nisbet. Ramiza Nazreen Nisha. Etana Violetti Novata. Senior Scholar, Education and Social Work, Kate O'Hara. Brittany Jane Oldfield. Cameron James Monteith Olif. Falzia Hassan Omer. Denise Jane O'Neill. Carly Marie Ormsby. Rachel Haley Owen. Selena Claire Oxborough. Chelsea Marie Page. Jessica Ann Pace. Melissa Leah Parkins. Kylie Catherine Parnell. Roman Elizabeth Patrick. Deloshni Pillay. Tanya Marie Popata. Miriama Ellen Popatahori. Lance Joseph Bernard Pope. Nicole Robin Powick Page. Rosemary Alma Price. Priya Kushla Rao. Olivia Grace Ray. Anna Maria Rebecca. Kylie Nicole Riddell. Maila Naiti Ngawamo Reddy. Joanna Marie Redmond. Casey Ridsdale. Anitra Petronella Roberts. Mary Catherine Robertson. Tess Emmeline Robertson Keane. Amelia Katie Robinson. Stacey Eden Robinson. Jessica Roberts. Yolanda Daisy Roy Wachowski. Ashif Ahmed Tashka. Diana Edith Estel Salter. Leah Morgan Searle. Sally Ann Schroff. Zoe Simpson. Melanie Kate Slessor. Ventella Sawana Solomone. Sharon Margaret Spurdle. Alina Maria Jean Stewart. Sinead Rebecca Sterling. Chloe Adele Stockman. Jessica Grace Nafanua Stars. Paige Cheyenne Renata Sturt. Tuhuinga Thelma Yingsing Sung. Louise Mary Sorrent. Chelsea Laura Swan. Emma Louise Sweeney. Samit Fatima Syed. Betty Tafa Soliai Uelese. Bonnie Ray Talamaival. Adam Tal Tamariki. Wadata Mihiwira Taunganga. Ian Matare Tahinu. Adele Therese Toto. Tolagi Teleso. Anne Mae Thompson. Nicole Margaret Thompson. Senior Scholar Education, Kathleen Ruth Todd. Nicole Joanna Tuinukuafair. Alexandra Kate Turner. Melissa Joy Susanna Ueseli. Sean Patrick Vandervold. Charlotte Van Gogh Buchanan. Kendall Patricia Van Rensburg. Anna Maria Valtuua. Adam Craig Vincent. Jonine Lena Waitford. Blair Andrew Walker. Tini Wahapayahua Walker. Natasha Leanne Wallace. Nicole Sarah Wallace. Melanie Jean Wormsley. Stephanie Wang. Hamish Wesley Ward. Hine au RPS Whare Aorere Taite McLean. Abigail Ann Wheeler. Danielle Haley Wheeler. Lauren Jessica Mary White. Angela Whittam. Nicole Francis Williamson. Edwina Fakatuma Mana Wolfgram. Maxwell Nathan Woodhead. Jade Louise Waith. Yutong Michelle Yu. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work. Jessica Rian Arcoy. Ashley Mae Balderston. Jean-Paul Bezosa. Emma Louise Camborn. Jessica Ann Coughlin. Thomas Samuel Gledhill. Manhara Jordine. Victoria Ann Gray. Keaton Dale Gregory. Shelley Lane Hoval. Anne Marie Howlett. Morgan Michelle Hunter. Jun Okumura. Lahana Karite Onosai. Kizito Chun Edu Onsunwa. Saeni Pita. Nicole Ann Preston. Mosese whangaringa moto. Shabana Shah. Angela Del Walter. Brittany Eve Weber. Morgan Sean Wilson. Letitia Marie Woods. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Distinction. Michaela Ann Bonner. Leslie Ann Bruce in Literacy Education. Megan Leah Clune. Carl Gordon Greenstreet. Elizabeth Catherine Lapish. Athena Helen London in Literacy Education. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Merit, Lisa Debbie Dahm. Jessica Jane Kelly in Literacy Education. Sweetie Viral Naik. Pauline Jane Tangiweto Pyle. Farzana Mahega bin Saheb. Nola Elizabeth Sutherland. Charlotte Victoria Walker. Postgraduate Diploma in Education, Claire Elizabeth Bailey. Robin Megan Bracey. Leslie Jane Drakeford in Literacy Education. Manoja Sujiwani Edari Wakrama. Fafita Fakatolo'o Kesta. Melavea Ta Aroha Huihui. Anita Krishna. Riddhi Rajiv Kumar. Hannah Rebecca Lendrum. Ngahiraka Mary Marsh. Shannon Marie Omar. Manava Ofapole. Carolyn Ann Purdy in Counselling. Jacqueline Julia Tofa in Literacy Education. Yan Ning Yuan. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Distinction, Jeremy Mark Lecomte. Gemma McGibney. Heather Dawn Spinetto. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Merit, Theagishvari Naidu. Brigitte Ruth Rohr. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision, Eliapo Lloyd Elisada. Postgraduate Diploma in Social Work, Esther Chinye Ego Adiosun. Adelia Teresa Ratila Bulatau. Vini Afototo Lale Petaru. Ofa Lutui. Postgraduate Diploma in Teaching, Secondary Field-Based, Matthew Anthony Dadley. Kai Bastian Fersjager. Wendy Paula Kirsty Gillen. Joshua John Irving. Ruby Christine Knight. Francesca Guanella Wanting Lee. Antonia Carmel McBride. Rebecca Jean McGrath. Nadine Lonuola Papali'i. Joanna Marie Pasco. Esther Michelle Rakete. Nicole Vin Yearns Hugh. Yolande May Tom. Leonie Jan Wethy. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with First Class Honours. Yvonne Yihan Liu. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Colleen Joy Feiberger. Rukshana Jabeen Khan. Bernardina Antonia Jacoba van Loon. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Ruta Ann Helen Chloe Rasmussen. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with First Class Honours, Ruth Choi. Senior Scholar, Education, John Paul Darrick. University Graduate Scholar, Alani Iwe Ngadeta Parker. Maria Pulishuk. Nicole Jessica Robinson. Senior Scholar Education, Alison K. Wills. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Julia Molly Henderson. To the degree of Master of Education with First Class Honours, Pauline Jane Adams. Carol Elsie Jarrett, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Distinction. Anthony David Jones. Ritika Rajni Krishnan. Holly Meredith Moore. Fazana Norzai. Andrea Mary Scanlon. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours, First Division, Katrina Louise Hoskin. Geetha Naidu. Rowena Clear Pearson. Susan Feongoaki Smith. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class on the Second Division, Savina Dorothy Jacobs. Jacqueline Eunice May Shaw. To the degree of Master of Social Work with Second Class Honours, First Division, Annette K. Gilbert. Sally Louise Raymond. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with First Class Honours, Lauren Marie Glass. Petra Godnyavits. Elisa Fetu Helu Warwick Ofamooni. Jonathan Peter Sampson. Midi Yuan Shu Willoughby. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with Second Class Honours, First Division, Lauren Nicole Bradley. Nicholas John Buckley. Keely Galen Merritt. Chi Zi Si To. Taryn Marie Skilling. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Malik Youssef Abushli. Michael Charles Dawson. Yeah. Nadine Claudette Erasmus. Woo-hoo! Beulah Vandana Musuku. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional, Xiao Yongjia.
I now call upon the Vice Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Education, Elizabeth Enid Anderson. From her background in teacher education, Elizabeth set out to conceptualise and describe the practice of drama education in a way that would assist student teachers or any teachers taking professional advancement courses to develop their practice for the primary classroom in this powerful area of pedagogy. Elizabeth. Patricia Ann Potter. Patricia characterised learning to design and problem solve in the context of hard materials by investigating how technologists learn and technology teachers teach. She theorised this characterisation using four different learning theories. Patricia. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Morrigan Susan Catherine Mullen in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Molly examined the economies of applied theatre in three theatre companies, providing a practice-based perspective on the strategies by which socially committed theatre makers manage their financial relationships. She identified possibilities for negotiating a way through this highly contested domain. Raywin K. Siulata in Education. Ray explored the reasons for Pacific learner success in English medium classrooms and the particular actions that teachers, leaders and facilitators enacted in enabling these learners to connect the worldviews, languages, literacy practices and experiences of their homes with the valued knowledge and literacy practices of schools. Alai Malalua to e tu'u tamahiri in Education. Ala researched factors of success from the perspectives of Tongan University graduates. She found that the two essential components of success for her participants were their Tongan upbringing within the home and their education at an English immersion school. Ala. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Education and Social Work.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for sustained excellence in teaching has been made to Dr. Eleanor Hoare in the School Learning Development and Professional Practice within the Faculty of Education. I call upon a student of that faculty, Julie Harper, to read the citation for Dr. Hoare.
It is my great honour to speak today about Dr. Eleanor Hoare's exceptional qualities as a teacher and mentor. In a teaching career that spans four decades, Eleanor has inspired learners at all stages of their educational journey, from young children to aspiring teachers, doctoral students, and those like me who return to tertiary study later in their teaching career. Her teaching and research interests are focused on learning and assessment in higher education, where she is internationally renowned. She has presented and published in this area over a number of years. However, her passion for teaching and learning extends far beyond academic publication, as she exemplifies good practice in all she does. Working alongside students, Eleanor instills in them a desire to learn and to fulfil their academic potential. Like my peers, I always felt challenged, encouraged, respected, and supported by Eleanor. Her phenomenal willingness and ability to share her deeply embedded content and pedagogical content knowledge with students extended far beyond the classroom walls. Through a combination of carefully structured and authentic activities and an experiential approach to learning, she has been a source of inspiration as an exceptional role model. Eleanor says that she aims to provide a motivating, learning-focused environment that results in success for all. Her model of teaching fosters student ownership of learning, at the same time engaging students deeply with course content, the lecturer, and their peers. Without doubt, as student feedback and results attest, Eleanor has been able to fulfil these aims. For me personally, Eleanor's paper was the highlight of my academic study, and she has provided me with the tools and confidence to want to continue my study further in the future. Dr. Eleanor Hoare's commitment to her profession and those she works alongside is beyond compare. She is undoubtedly a worthy recipient of this Sustained Excellence in Teaching Award.
Another award for early career excellence in teaching has been made to Mrs. Gail Ledger in the Curriculum and Pedagogy within the Faculty of Education and Social Work. I call upon a student of that faculty, Nicola Zimmerman, to read the citation for Mrs. Ledger.
I had a complete change in attitude towards mathematics while I was a student of Gail's. Coming back to study after practicing architecture, I was eager to embark on a new teaching career. But, like many of my other students, I was anxious about my own mathematical understanding and how to teach it. We all quickly became aware that Gail was committed to reducing the mathematical anxiety of the students in her classes. By focusing on student engagement and providing learning experiences that bridge pedagogy and content, our anti-maths tendencies were soon replaced with a new commitment for the subject. And many of us have Gail to thank for fixing our relationship with maths. Gail is approachable, quick to respond to queries, and generous when injecting lessons with her own experiences. I particularly enjoyed how she spiced up maths problems with content we could all relate to. Gail is having a party and has three bottles of champagne to share equally with her three friends. What fraction of one bottle of champagne does Gail and each of her friends get? 3 divided by 4, we suddenly realise the importance of fractions. Gail uses technology to strengthen and enhance learning. She models how technology can be successfully integrated without becoming a distraction or a gimmick. Gail walks the walk. She demonstrates exemplary practice and she allows students to develop their own mathematical understandings. In the 30 years that Gail has been teaching, I truly believe her commitment to and belief in her students has remained a priority. Auckland University's graduate profile states that students should leave with a love and enjoyment of ideas, discovery and learning. Gail has successfully enabled this to happen, and it is my absolute pleasure to be able to honour Gail's achievements today with the Auckland University's Early Career Teaching Excellence Award.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. While you are standing, this would be a good time for you, the graduates, to show your appreciation of your families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped you as you achieved your qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.